And welcome in to Men's Action, Men's Basketball, Savannah State University, here taking on our Lane College Dragons. I'm Tyler Newkirk on the call alongside Jacarri Relf. And we're off and underway, tip off in possession to the Tigers. They'll probe, dribbling drive, and we're gonna have an early foul call. Great attack there by Marcus Scott. As he's able to draw the foul, that foul will be called on Tyler Henry, and Scott will go to the free throw line for two. He'll be off on the first free throw. Able to convert the second. Jacarri, what do you think is going to be the keys to this game here today? We saw a tough game in our first of the doubleheader as our Lady Dragons were able to get the win. But what do you think are going to be keys here in this men's game?
I don't know. I would definitely say that I know that the Lane College men's team are a great shooting team, so I would definitely say they should stick to their strengths of shooting the ball. And if that don't work, find something down low.
And you just saw right there on cue, Ariston Johnson with the mid-range jumper. As you just saw, Zion Williams missed the three. But right now, offense looking good both ways as D'Angelo Brown tried to go in and put it down over two defenders. He was able to draw the foul, and he'll put himself on the line for two. D'Lo Brown, the 6'4 senior out of Detroit, Michigan. He'll get the first of two to fall. And the second is good. Ball pushed ahead up court for the Tigers. They swing it around the perimeter. Drive out, kicked out to Scott. Scott for the three, and it's good. Marcus Scott, corner three. Johnson dribbles at the top of the key. They swing it, finds Johnson again. He'll look down low for Brandon Dansaw. Dansaw drive baseline. He goes up, great block. Great defense, great block there by number 24, Andrew Okorodu.
Nice fake. He got him with that one, sky high.
Always love when we get our international players on from the different teams on the roster. So I want to definitely make sure I give number 24, Andrew Okorodu, a shout out. Out of Lagos, Nigeria.
Oh, yeah.
responds there with the short arm. She tried to float it up with the left, and possession is going to stay with the Tigers. 4-4. 18:03 left here in the first half. Williams will push it in to Scott. Scott will push it over to Bonds. Bonds will drive. Over Dansaw, he's going to come up short.
He was in the air for a few minutes.
Great hustle there by Okorodudu. Keeping possession alive for his team. You're going to get Zion Williams taking it out again. Baseline out of bounds.
Yeah, I saw that.
William pulls it out. 13 seconds left on the shot clock.
Alley-oop. Almost.
Backdoor. Oh, I say it's great idea.
Yeah, that was a great idea.
Tyler Henry is going to get the foul call in his favor. He pulled up from mid-range. Believe they're going to get number 11, Adrian Bonds, there on the foul. And Henry's going to be at the line shooting, too. First is going to be good for Henry. A freshman be playing a big role. A 6'3 freshman out of Brooklyn, New York.
Brooklyn.
He's going to hit on the second. Got a chance to see him play before he went on winter break. Mm-hmm. And he had a really good game against Union University. That was the last game we had the chance to call and see before we left. Because you're going to see Williams for the three, and that's going to go over the backboard and out of bounds. But Henry is definitely one of those key players that they're going to look to depend on as the season progresses.
Yeah.
Johnson will look to work some offense in the Seren. Seren's going to go up. He's going to be off. So Marcus Scott's going to find the rebound. He's going to push it. He pushes ahead to Deloach.
Reset.
Right now you're seeing pretty fluid offense both ways. The ball finds Bond. Bond's going to drive. Too strong. And an offensive foul. They're going to get Adrian Bonds on an offensive foul. As Brandon Dansaw did a great job of sacrificing himself down low and taking a charge.
Yeah. Though that didn't work out like they wanted to, I do admire the pace Savannah State is playing with. They're not rushing anything. They're taking their time and trying to get the open basket. And that's what basketball is about.
And I'll tell you what you oftentimes also don't see is the bigs taking the charges from the guards. And
yeah.
You saw that on that play as Dansaw stepped up. Turnover for the Dragons.
Three-point
Tigers
jumper.
Get it.
Oh. Still. Three. Man, the success isn't really coming from three this early on in the game.
And I'll tell you what, it's still early, so they still have a chance to continue to shoot it. I think that was a great shot by Scott. The Dragons going to run offense. Johnson's going to take the three. That'll be off. Andrew flies in there. They're going to push the ball ahead. The pressure. Great pass. Amaru Bryant tracks it down.
Pick.
Great no look. Ugh. He just missed it. That was a beautiful no look right there by Bryant.
Yes, it
Bryant
was.
Bryant to Okorodudu, down low, just unable to finish and convert on the and one. And it looks like we're going to go into our first media timeout of this game. And what has been a very back and forth start here, 4-6 lead in favor of the Dragons. We're going to step away and we'll be right back. here we are out of timeout, out of our first media timeout of the game. Andrew Okorududu at the line shooting two. First one's going to be strong. He'll miss. He'll be off on two. She got an inadvertent horn. He got an inadvertent horn as he's not supposed to necessarily sub in after a missed basket. I thought he can only sub in after a made basket, but nonetheless, they got the sub. Johnson to swing it over to Henry. Henry for the three.
Three.
It's good. Tyler Henry.
Great three-point shot. Three from Bryant. Savannah State. Miss.
Lane looking to run some offense here. Get it to Dansaw. Henry a drive baseline. Just a bad pass there. It's too low for Dansaw to handle. As you're going to see, Joyner's going to push the ball up court. First mention and a cheap foul. Cheap foul there by Sarin. Is it going to get Sarin Ott there on the foul? As you're going to get a big group substitution here for the Dragons. They're going to do a full swap. You also see some new faces out there on the court for the Tigers as well. Brian to take the ball out of bounds baseline. You will have the combination of Bryant, Scott, Ashford, and our Joyner. Don't have 00 listed here on the roster. Nonetheless, he'll make an appearance as well. Scott will have it in the corner. He'll swing it over to Joyner. 15 seconds left on the shot clock. Joyner with the drive. Scott in the corner to Bryant. Bryant for the corner. Three is no good. And big rebound there by Edaz Fox. And he'll set up the offense. He drives. He kicks it over. 4-3. It's good. Daniel Hill for the three-point ball.
And see, that's what I was telling you, Tyler. The Lane College team, men's team, they are a team of great shooters. So I'm not surprised to see that they are already great from the three this early on in the game.
And you like the back-to-back action. It's full court, high action packed, and Dre Johnson's going to drive. Nearly get the and one. But I like the action. I like the back and forth. It's high paced. They're running the floor, getting back on defense, and they're active on both ways. As you saw Lou Johnson being very aggressive on that last play.
Yes, yes.
His first free throw, a rim out. We have a substitution change here for the Tigers. As Andrew Okorududu will come back into the game, as well as Zion Williams. And off
Johnson
on the second free throw
both.
As well.
Drive.
Scott with a hard drive.
Great.
Scott with the hard physical drive. And that's what they're going to have to do right there to battle themselves back into this game. Continue to drive and attack the basket.
Yeah, because the three-point shot just hasn't been working for them. Scott knocks down the first free throw for Savannah State. He's a freshman out of Hinesville, Georgia. Knocks down the second.
Substitution change here. It's number five. It's going to check in. Trey Deloach. He'll replace Amaru Bryant. You want to be sure to take a shout out or give a shout out to our mass communications department. This is a completely student-run production that we do, of course, with the assistance of our advisor, Pamela Peters. You saw the tough drive there by Deloach, able to draw the foul. As you'll see, another substitution here for the Dragons. It's Kendravius Webster's going to check in. He'll replace Joseph Logan. Ball kicked in the corner. Okorodoodle just happened to lose the ball out of bounds. Great rebound.
Still can't get it going from three.
Well, I think, Jacarri, you got to think. The Tigers are very fortunate. They've had some misguided turnovers here early on, but to only be down 6 points thus far, I think that's pretty good.
Yeah. I would just say that instead of trying to shoot the three ball, they should definitely get inside the paint more often going forward in this game.
Foul called there. Our number three, Zion Williams. Ball's going to be taken out. Baseline out of bounds. Another substitution. Bryan will check in for Williams. And Webster's going to take it out. Baseline out. Throw it in to Ray White. Ray White's going to dribble and drive. He looks to attack. And it rolls out.
Pass. Another. Okay. Nice drive.
That's the case right there. Bryant just running into a bigger body than Ray White.
Pull up jumper. Oh, he got foul. Nice job being aggressive on the fast break.
Let's just see some chirping back and forth. Great job by the referee jumping in. Just kind of making sure you want to keep it under control. That's Deloach is going to be at the line here for two. First one is up and good. Second free throw is going to be good as well. More substitutions. 12:25 left here in this first half. Score of 8-12 in favor of the Dragons. Fresh bodies has definitely been a key of this game, considering the fact there's been a lot of back and forth action, a lot of fast break opportunities both ways.
Mm-hmm. A little air ball.
Yeah. Great look ahead there.
Ooh, steal. Nice steal. The Dragons pushing the ball up the court. Pull up. Oh. Now Savannah State pushing the ball up the court.
Great recovery there by Scott. Stand with it. See, he tripped himself a little bit. Kind of a not top team kind of play, but I mean, he kept possession alive for his team. Definitely great focus and concentration. As we'll get our second media timeout, we're going to stay right here with you. 11:43 left here in the first half. Again, 8-12 score. Jacarri, how do you like the pace of this game thus far? How do you like the pace? How do you like the flow?
The pace is great. The pace and the flow of this game is great. I'm just saying that for Savannah State to move forward going on in the game, they're going to have to go to the paint a lot more often. Early on in the game when they were shooting three-pointers, it wasn't really working in their favor compared to the Dragons. So I would say going for it in the game, Savannah need to hit that paint.
So who would you say this pace right now, this fast-paced game that we've been seeing here in the first half, as we move along and as we get into the second half, who does that pace more so lean in favor of, Savannah State or Lane?
Right now, I would have to say the Dragons. It's more in favor of the Dragons because they've been executing on the fast break. They've been moving the ball. They've been getting the jumpers. Everything is going their way right now.
Yeah, I'd agree. And right now, again, as we said it on our previous broadcast, it's free throws. Free throws, free throws, free throws, especially in tightly contested games like this. You're going to have to be able to take advantage of those free opportunities that you're given.
Yes.
And what better free basket or free point to get than a free throw?
Yes.
Trey DeLoach at the line out of the timeout for two free throws.
I'm looking at Savannah State's roster, and it looks like most of their players are coming out of Georgia. It's pretty interesting.
Got a lot of hometown boys.
Yes, a lot of hometown.
And I also think, you know, just looking at their roster, she's going to be off on the second one as it nearly rolls in. They have a nice mix. They have a nice mix of freshmen, sophomore, juniors, and seniors. It's not too lopsided in any regard. I think, you know, that's one thing, whereas Lane, you know, they have primarily seniors. Savannah State has a really good mix, and you got to think that's an advantage if you're Coach Broadnecks.
Yeah, I agree, Tyler.
Looks like the ref is having a discussion with the scoreboard operators. Action will resume as Henry's going to inbound it to Mason. Mason will kick it back to Henry. Henry will drive baseline. He attacks up and under.
Missed the reverse layup right there.
Scott will push it over to Parks. Parks for the
nice three.
Nice three.
Seems the Tigers are warming up.
And now you got a tie game. You got to play defense right now. Defense, take advantage of your opportunities.
Nice two-point bucket.
That's a great
Ray
big
White. And Ray White himself is from Georgia, Atlanta,
yeah.
Georgia.
And that's a great big man move right there. He's going to the spin cycle, backing him down. That's old school basketball.
Old school.
Trey DeLoach there with the turnaround jumper. Again, down low on the post. Kind of a rarity right now in this day and age in basketball. Going down low to the post. Turnaround jumpers back to your basket.
Yeah, today's game is they live and die from the three-pointer. Shooting is definitely. Turnover. From
great hustle there by Webster. Nearly able to get his team an extra possession. And that'll be one thing to keep an eye on as well. Second chance points. Who can get their team checking second and third and maybe even fourth chance points?
Yeah.
Who can keep things alive for them?
Definitely looks like both teams are doing their job on the glass right now.
Joyner swing it out the sky.
Open
Scott
three.
For the three. Rebounded by Henry as Henry will bring the ball up court. Looking for the mismatch. See if they find the mismatch down low, and they do.
Down to Ray White. Nice jumper.
Brandon Dansall with the mid-range jumper.
That's a good basketball. Nice, high-quality shot.
Right now, Jacarri, you're seeing great defensive intensity both ways. You're going to see a missed three-pointer there by Joyner. But you're seeing great defensive intensity both ways.
Yeah. Ooh, nice fake. Oh, nice try. That's a great move. Tigers got another turnover.
Mason will bring the ball up court for the Dragons. 9 minutes left here in this first half. He'll look to set the offense up. Swings it over to Henry. Henry will drive baseline. Kicks it out to Seren. Seren will be off the mark for the three. Rebound collected by Ashford. Joyner will push it up. Sends it over to Parks. Parks for the three. He'll be off. Rebound, Ashford. Joyner for the three. He'll be off. And Brandon Dansall collect the rebound. And Lane will look to attack.
I feel like I've only seen one three-pointer go down for Savannah State in this in this game.
Listen, the rim is definitely not open yet.
Yeah, they're definitely in a funk right now.
It's still close.
They're doing a great job on the boys, though. Savannah is doing a great job on the boys.
The Tigers look to work some offense. Here's Joyner, a call out the play. He'll swing it over to Parks. Parks to Joyner. Joyner for the corner three. He'll be off once again. Rebound collected by Miles Lee. And Joyner's going to get the foul call against Mason. Looks like we have another media timeout.
What's your opinion of the shooting game Savannah State has displayed so far, Tyler?
Well, listen, I'm personally a firm believer in shooters are going to shoot, right? I mean, that's the only way you're going to hit is if you continue to shoot. You know, you can't expect to hit any three-point shot if you don't shoot them. The key is taking smart three-point shots. Right now, I think they've done a pretty good job, just unable to find it, you know, unable for the shot to find the bottom of the net, but you know, if they continue to get good looks at the basket, you got to take them.
Yeah.
And that, as this game goes along, chances are they're not going to miss as often. I see you looking at me. But chances are they're not going to miss as often as they have. Probability says they're going to hit one.
You're right.
Maybe
they did.
Two.
They did. They did hit one.
But as you shoot, once you see that one go through the rim, you might look at another one, and that there goes two, and now you're starting to get the momentum, the confidence to continue to shoot.
Hopefully, I see another three-pointer go down for Savannah State. Then it'll be two.
They got to be open, though. That's the thing. If they're not open, okay. If they're contested, obviously it's a bad shot. But if they're open, you got to let it fly.
Of course. But I would say that they should let it fly from the mid-range rather than the three.
Agreed. Henry will throw the tough pass to Fox. Henry will end up in the back. Thought he got fouled on that mid-range shot. Joyner will push it up. Throws in the corner to Bryant. Bryant for the three. In and out. It's the three-point game. Was that a good three-point shot?
It was nice, but it didn't go down. Now that's how you shoot a three-pointer right there.
So that's right there. That's Mason showing
that's how you
Bryant how to knock it down.
Uh-oh. Three from Savannah
there
State.
There it is.
Yeah. That's the second one.
There it is. Marcus Scott. Marcus Scott opening
the rim
up.
He's knocking down for his team.
That might spark something in his teammate's mind as Edaz Fox works on Scott. He'll step back.
I like that. That was nice.
He'll step back for the long two.
Yeah, that was quick.
Joyner works on Fox. He'll look, cross court pass to the corner.
Uh-oh, I thought he was finna put it.
Shoot. I thought he got away with a travel.
Savannah State trying to get something going inside.
4 seconds, 3, 2. Ooh.
Oh, I thought that was an and one.
Just not a smart, that's not a smart foul call. Not a smart foul by Edaz Fox, especially with 1 second left on the shot clock.
Yeah.
I mean, you already forced the baseline into a tough shot. No lead to swat there. That'll put Marcus Scott on the free throw line for two. And he'll miss the first one. Substitution made as you see Henry checks out of the game. And he'll go 0 for 2 as Andrews there for the rebound. Scott thought about the three.
Nice little floater, rebound. Oh, nice block.
Saran Ach just going, I mean, my goodness, he just grabbing the ball out of the air.
Yeah. Doing his JaVale McGee impression. Ooh, nice foul.
So they're going to get a rejoinder there for the foul call. Brandon Dansall will be at the line shooting two. And he'll be off on the first. So right now we're seeing a very lackluster performance at the free throw line from both teams.
I definitely haven't seen the Dragons miss too many in this game, but I did just see the first miss. I think the first miss there.
Well, and I say lackluster for the simple fact that that kind of killed the girls last game. You know, just when you had a chance to continue to expand or your lead, it's expected you miss some free throws. But this is a good team. It's just a great charge take. The second of the game there for Dansaw, stepping in front of the guard, taking the foul.
Nice, I missed a foul.
But being able to hit those free throws and continue to expand on the lead, I think, is one thing they have to take advantage of. Fox will bring the ball up court. Look to set the offense up. Ott with the screen. Fox with the travel. Yep. It's like a gallop and then a step. Like it was a step and then a gallop.
Step.
Yeah.
Yeah, high step.
Okoradudu will check back into the game for Zion Henderson. Brian will bring the ball up court. Look to get things going here. Work some offense. He'll pass it to Parks. Parks will give it to Scott. Little three-man weave action.
Moving the ball. Open two. Miss. The Dragons doing a good job of moving the ball. Nice little three.
Saran Ach with the deep ball. So 3-point shot is open for the Dragons. They found the bottom of the net a few times. That's in and out once again for the Tigers. Off the chest of Okoradudu, recovered by Deloach as he misses on a putback. Saran Ach will push it up. He'll pull the ball back out, and he dives. Fox will set up the offense. He probes.
Nice little in and out. That was a nice in and out. Cross.
It's a great probe right there. Great probe and attack by Fox. Getting himself an easy opportunity at 2 points. So we have another timeout. 3:58 left here in the first half. 25-17 lead in favor of the Dragons. We will take the opportunity to step away this timeout. So please stay tuned. 50 seconds away. And action will be back here at the JF Lane Gymnasium. Again, Tyler Newkirk alongside Jacarri Relf on the call as we're back as Fox shoots two.
Sky knocked down the first.
He'll be off second. On a second. Hey, Jacarri, one thing I just thought about. They let 1911 grab two microphones.
It took you this long to figure that out?
Listen, I just thought about it, you know. Got a shout out on Omega Sci-Fi Fraternity Incorporated.
I got to shout out the greatest fraternity, Cap Alpha Psi.
Listen, I just said the greatest first, so, you know. It's royal.
Both of them are great.
Gold.
Both
there
of them
go.
Are great.
1911 was a great year. We just say that.
Yeah, great year.
You know, November 17th, 1911, you know.
And, you know, especially, of course, you know, we have a great relationship with the bros. You know,
absolutely.
Y'all some nice, cool dudes.
We definitely look out for one another. As Parks is going to step out of bounds. Lane's going to get the ball back. We also, while we on the Greek topic, really fast, we want to give a shout out to the women of Delta Sigma Theta Sorority Incorporated, who will be celebrating their Founders Day on January 13th. I believe that's Monday.
I love me some Deltas.
Oh, man. Oh, man. Back to the action. Syringe with the
nice
three.
Little three. Hey, he's knocking the three-pointers down. That's like got to be like his second or third one.
I tell you right now, he's had a sneaky great game. Like you just said, he's been knocking the three ball down.
Oh, yeah.
But Serena is really,
he's been knocking him down. His jumper has been on.
They might have to think about starting to expand out there on that perimeter.
Yeah.
Scott's going to be short on a floater. Serenach with the rebound again. Daniel Hill will push it up. Calling out the orders. He'll swing it over to Lou Johnson. Johnson to Webster. Johnson to drive baseline. Webster get the loose ball and Ott.
He is hooping. Saran is hooping.
Scott, she was fouled in the backcourt by Johnson. He'll look to cut into this 14-point deficit. And he does. Substitutions made. Number 15 and number 12, Zion Anderson and Larson Ashford to check into the game. Hill brings it up court. He'll dump it down to Webster. Webster's
nice
drive.
Nice little inside. And try to dish it. I like how he's playing, though. This is going to be a big game for Shrine. He's been all over the floor, rebounding, layups, free throws, three-pointers. He's doing it all right now. As the old school would say, definitely continue to feed the hot man.
150 left here in the first half. 20-second shot clock. Parks will send it out. Double zero. He'll kick it to Scott. Hey, call him double zero. What's his name was on the roster? He drives. In and out for him. It's Webster get the rebound. He'll push the ball up court.
Like how the Dragons are moving the ball right now. Another three-pointer. And that's Miles Lee from Hughes, Arkansas.
Great ball movement there on that last possession. So now they're going to apply some pressure defensively. Lee thought about getting a steal. That's a trip. They're going to get Lee on a foul.
That three ball was a beauty. Another bucket for Deloach.
Henderson to check in for Okra Doodle. Six seconds left here. Hill brings the ball up court. Webster a drive.
He recovers.
10 second shot clock. The
team is moving the ball pretty good right now. Another three from Lee. Saran rebounds another and gets another bucket. He is doing it out there.
Saran Otch, again, I mean, just balling as they're going to go up 15 points, and you'll see the Tigers call a timeout.
He's been all over the floor.
Yeah.
All over the floor.
And on both ends, offense and defense.
Yes.
Coach Broad next. Head basketball coach for the Tigers. They look to get one possession left out of this half. As I believe the shot clock is turned off, they'll have, I believe, 23.1 seconds left here in the first half. Tigers will take it out. Sideline out of bounds. Looking for what probably be one possession. Williams the dribble, top of the key. 12-second game clock. 10.
He's holding the ball for the last shot. Nice little fake. And there's a foul on the play.
Gonna get a foul on Miles Lee there. He's gonna get two free throws coming up for Zion Williams. Looking to make this a 13-point game, as you'll see multiple substitutions by both sides. Williams to convert. 3.8 seconds left here. Hill's gonna push, he pushes it up, and the clock doesn't start.
Man, it's a lot of holdup right now.
As you can tell, Coach Bazemore very upset. Shot clock just didn't start.
Yeah, you know Bazemore mad when you get to throwing that towel.
They'll put 2.5 seconds left on the clock. 2-1, no shot.
And he makes it after the buzzer. It would have been nice if he would have got it up in time.
So we're going to the half, 36-23. The Dragons up in what has been a very back and forth first half as the Dragons found themselves able to pull away later on in the first half. Second half should be very action-packed. This should be a great second half. Please stay tuned, and we'll be back after halftime.
And we're back for the continuation of the second half of this basketball game. Savannah State University against Lane College Dragons.
Good block. Good block there by the Lord. Deloach is going to get the two as well. It's a great job on both ends by Deloach. Defense leads to offense. Still make the first strike, or take the first strike, excuse me, in the second half. Dance all! Going for the big slam. He got caught by the rim. Great follow by D'Lo Brown, and she's going to get the putback and expand his lead back to 13. Scott's going to drive, and, excuse me, not Scott. Zion Williams is going to drive and get fouled. Look, I wish they could see the clock. The clock is stopped at 19:11. You see that, right?
Oh, you still on this 19:11
thing. No, we were talking about it earlier. We were talking about it in the first half, so I just thought how ironic that it stopped on 19:11.
Speaking of that, shout out to my grandfather, who's an alumni, Kappa Sig.
The Brus.
He just had his birthday a couple days ago. Happy belated birthday to you, Grandpa.
The oldest pace, Calvin Sig royalty.
He crazy 70. About his bros.
Man, it's the 70 bros, man. He's outside of corner three on the last possession for the Tigers.
Tigers on a fast break. He stops for the three.
Serena's going to get the rebound. Lou's going to set the offense up. He calls the play out. He'll send it over to D'Lo Brown. He'll look to swing it. Great back action. Down low to Logan. Logan with the spin. And he'll lose it out of bounds. Turnover Dragons. He runs the offense. He'll swing it over to Bonds. Bonds for the three.
Miss.
He'll be off. That's another three, Jacarri.
Savannah, they can't keep trying to shoot themselves out the funk. It's only getting worse.
As you saw, the two almost going there for Johnson. they're definitely going to have to be more aggressive in attacking versus shooting the three ball.
Yeah.
But they're only down 10. They've cut into the lead a little bit from the one they went into half with, facing.
They put on a little bit of a run because before halftime started, it was like 19-31. And now it's 28-38.
Bonds with the dribble. He'll go to the drive. He'll kick it over to Deloach. Deloach will look to get into the paint. He pumps. He kicks it to the corner. Williams will be off for the three. And loose ball foul on Okoradudu. Now, right now, if you're the Tigers, dribbling, driving will probably be their best friend.
Yeah.
If you lane, you probably would think they're going to sag off a little bit and kind of force them to hit a shot. But they need to look to get aggressive. If the lane opens up for you to make something happen at the rim, so be it. If not, that's when you got to look to dish it out for the three-point ball. But they're just not looking to work the ball inside enough. Johnson, a corner three. And again, that's the dribble drive. You see Bonds is going to drive, and he's going to get the foul call. He'll be at the free throw line for two. But as you saw with Lane on that last possession, they dribbled and drove. And when that happened, are they going to call on the floor? But Lane dribbled and drove. They were able to find it in the corner. I believe that was Hill for the three. Johnson for the three. But definitely, those long balls right now aren't working. We have to continue to be aggressive. Yeah. And that's what Coach Brodnax was just talking about to his team. Keys to the second half. Right now, especially coming off of that first half slump, the keys to the second half that we have is definitely the Tigers, as we just said, getting that shot going. They have to find a way to get into their rhythm, to get some easy buckets for themselves, and that starts with attacking the rim. If they can attack the rim, draw some fouls, maybe get some easy looks at basket, that'll open up their shooting game.
Yeah.
Free throws. Free throws is also another key, something that we harped on in the first half. Who can win a free throw game? When they do hit a chance at those easy opportunities, can they take advantage of those free throws? Thank you to all the support still in here in the gym. Lane College family, friends, visitors coming out to support both the women and men's basketball teams here today. So we also want to just please tell everyone to be safe. Storms are picking up outside. We do have some tornado warnings in areas, so just please be safe and aware of the news. D'Angelo Brown is going to miss the mid-range jumper. Bonds will push. He'll drive, and he'll be off the mark. And Lou Johnson is going to get the rebound and push ahead.
Nice bucket from the Dragons.
That was a great block by Okoradoodle, but an even better follow there by Logan. Staying with the Forest team as Deloach is going to get to the free throw line after we just talked about easy buckets.
Trey knocks down the first. And knocks down the second.
One or two from the free throw line on that last trip. 14-point game here. So Webster looked to work some offense. He dribbles to the corner. Johnson defended by Joyner. Johnson's going to pull up mid-range. He'll be off. Great follow there by Webster.
Savannah's success hasn't come from the three, but it's been through them getting to the paint, getting to the basket, and free throws. So if they're going to have a chance to get back in this game, they need to continue to do those things.
Yeah, and Jacarri.
Still a lot of time left.
Yeah, and I was going to say, one thing I'm noticing about Lane, that Lane is doing a better job of Savannah State. They're just hanging around the rim.
Yeah.
When you hang around the rim, good things tend to happen, especially when it comes to second chance opportunities, as Webster's going to get the left-hand hook shot there. But good things happen when you hang around the rim.
For sure.
We're going to have another clock issue, it looks like. DeJuan Curry, his first entrance into the game. Number one, he'll check in. He'll replace Serene. And 15-16 is put on the clock. 15 minutes, and now 10 seconds. It's Bonds will look to work his offense. thought about the three. He'll throw it down to Okoradoodle. And he'll get the hard part, too. As, again, we have another scoreboard issue going on here. Because we're not necessarily sure if it's the board itself or something going on, or maybe it's something with fouls or points or whatever the case may be. But definitely a lot of stoppages in this game.
Why isn't he on the roster?
As I heard, it looks like we have a technical on the court. Unsure of exactly what the call was, but Scott's free throw is gonna roll off the front of the rim. Still unable to cut into this lead. We'll definitely be sure to try to get some clarification on what that last call was. But action is back, and that's resumed. Johnson pushes it ahead. He pushes it to Webster. Webster's going to drive and almost gets the and one.
Nice effort.
Marcus Scott's going to pick up his first foul of the game. Kendravius Webster at the line. He's going to be off on the first one. Substitutions made here by Savannah State. And he's going to get that one to flat in. Great trap. Good trap in the corner. He's out of bounds.
That was nice defense. Great trap.
It looked like he stepped out of bounds. I thought he might have stepped out before the foul.
It did look like he stepped out according to this monitor. We got a nice little angle.
Williams going to swing it over. And a turnover there. Turnover for Deloach. Johnson's going to push it up. Ariston, that is. He'll find Dansaw. He'll be off. He keeps it alive. Ariston Johnson, corner three. That'll be off. Kendravius West just goes up. Logan to Webster. Webster to Dansaw. Oh, Dansaw's going to miss.
If I was him, I would have tried to dunk that one. You got to in that situation.
All right, now listen. Would he have made it over the two defenders?
He could have, yeah. Because they were out of place. They were still up in the air when his teammate dished the ball off of him. So he could have done it. That's why he's smiling. You know he could have. You know he should. Everybody in the gym was making noise because they wanted him to do it.
He makes both free throws. Ball worked around out of the pressure. Have an extended man. Got to watch the roller. They get Okoradoodle on the foul call. 31-47 score here. 13 minutes and 40 seconds left in the second half. Ariston Johnson's shot's going to be a little bit too strong. Ball recovered by Deloach. Williams will push it ahead in the corner for Bonds. It's good. It's good. Corner three, Adrian Bonds.
Nice three.
Could that be the spark? Could that have potentially started something?
I don't think so.
Well, it started something for Lane.
And the Dragons respond with a three-pointer of their own. Nice pump fake.
Just one of those things. They got Joseph Logan in the air. I'm not gonna lie, some pump fakes are hard to hold off on. Some.
If you know how to sell it, you can make a defender do just about anything.
Uh-huh. They'll work the ball around. Deloach will swing it over.
Nice move. That was smart basketball. He saw the gap in the court. Took advantage.
That was a great finish there by Larson Ashford, excuse me. Webster will find Johnson. Johnson, that is. Lou Johnson. That's that mid-range we're talking about, Jacarri.
Oh, yeah.
Bonds will push. He'll kick it out. Joiner for three.
I'm still not sold. I'm still not sold.
But listen, that's two within the past 2 minutes, 1 to 2 minutes. Lou will look for the mid-range again. He'll be off. Deloach will push it. He'll find Williams. Williams will drive. He'll take the two.
Savannah State making a little run.
Great finish. Great finish there by DeJuan Curry. Getting a feed from Miles Lee. So see a little bit of talking, a little pushing and shoving.
Man, DeJuan, is he okay? You saw it?
Yeah, man, you saw the referee. Fox to Lou Johnson. He's going to be strong. Curry keeps it alive. Lee with the rebound. We have a push ahead, Zion Williams. He'll throw it back to Deloach.
I thought you was going to dunk it for a second.
Listen, Edodge Fox made an executive decision to step out of the way. Smart man. 11-point game here, 11-point lead for the Dragons. Turnover there by Webster. Deloach needs some help. As it looks like Coach Bazemore is looking for a timeout. Okay, we're going to grant this a media timeout. We're going to take our first break here, the second half. And what is action is picking up here in the second half. Stay tuned. This should be a good one. Back here out of break. 10:52 left to go here in the second half. 11-point lead for the Dragons, 54-43. As the Tigers are trying to start, six players on the court. Finally decides to leave. Okay, and they're just switching around. The Williams gonna bring the ball up court. And he's gonna attack. He attacks Fox. And great finish.
He almost blocked it.
Listen, Gregory Talbot is a big boy.
Yeah. I don't know if you know this, Tyler, but he's from France.
Yeah. The Frenchman.
Lane is still knocking it down from three. Their shooting has been on this game.
I'll tell you what, that was a confident looking shot. I actually didn't mind that shot there by Williams. It was confident. It wasn't like it was forced. He had a good look at it. Great look down to Okoradudu. Great find there by Deloach. They look to pick this intensity up defensively. 10-point game. Fox will have the ball. He'll shoot. He'll be off.
Nice rebound by Talbot. Trying to get his first bucket. It didn't go.
Got to convert. Williams will push it to Scott. Great hands by Fox. Fox, he'll look to drive. Hill to Lee.
I thought Talbot got another rebound. He got to get it back up on his feet.
See, Osh frustrated there. Watch the corner, Scott. He'll take it and in and out.
Uh-oh. Have an injury.
Is it a cramp? Nah, that looks like he might be cramping up. As you hope, that's all it is. You hope it's just a cramp. Yeah. Looks like he's being stretched out over there by the trainer. It's definitely a key player. You hate to see go out with anything major. I think it is. That's what it is. It's a cramp. Looks like they're over there stretching him out. They just flipped him over on his stomach. 8:55 left in the game. Or in the second half. You know, who knows? We might get an overtime game here with the men. You saw overtime finish last game.
That women's game was amazing. Both teams came out and competed, and I don't care what nobody says. Savannah State women's team, they were hitting some big shots in that game. Like, it was amazing. Like, the shot that stuck out to me was when one of their players hit a 4-point shot, got fouled at the three, and still sunk it. If she would have made that free throw, she would have tied up the game. But, you know, after that, Lane sealed the game. But they still competed. They definitely brought their A game today.
I tell you what, like you just said, that was a great finish. I mean, you know, I kind of hope we get a finish like that here in this game. But at the same time, that means the Dragons are going to let the Tigers come back.
Oh, yeah.
And make this a tightly contested game as –
I don't think I've ever witnessed an overtime game featuring the Dragons.
I tell you what, if Miles Lee keeps hitting big-time three-point shots like that in defenders' faces, I don't think we'll be seeing an overtime game.
Yeah.
The joint is going to look to drive, find some work. He'll push it to the corner to the Loach. And Deloach is going to draw the foul on D'Lo Brown. Now to put Deloach on the free throw line for what is a one-on-one.
He's been knocking down free throws for Savannah all game.
He'll get the second one to fall. 49-60. Fox bring it up court. Swings it to Henry. Henry looks to find an open man. He'll find D'Lo Brown down low with the smaller defender. He'll back him down and no good.
Look good for a second. Ooh, nice little snatch.
Great hustle by Fox. Yeah. Keeping the ball alive. That's that second, third chance points. He'll swing it over the dance hall for the two.
He had the gem on their feet just now.
I tell you what, the crowd was about ready to erupt. Had he hit that dance hall,
that was
whenever
a
he hit that
sloppy, though.
Man.
He crossed himself and got his balance back.
Have another media timeout.
He was a little sloppy, but he got it. He got it. I'm not even gonna laugh because I know that I can't even do that crossover he just did.
Shout out to our cheerleaders here. Went out loud and proud.
Yes, they definitely put on in the games.
It's definitely always a greater energy when they're out here. I mean, it seems like both teams play, both teams being our men and our women, they seem to play a little bit better.
Yeah.
Because I think, I don't know if you've seen the video on, I think that was surfacing around social media, but the video of, I think they were high schoolers. Well, they might not have been high schoolers, but the cheerleaders, they were doing that stump cheer that they were just doing. I don't know if you've seen that.
High schoolers?
I think it was either it was the high school or it was grade school. It was one of them, but I saw the video.
Today?
No, it's surfacing around social media, that stump. You know, I don't know. I'm not.
I guess I gotta look it up.
Bonds will hit the first free throw. But yeah, you see in two different kinds of schools do the stump, and one school try to imitate another.
Oh yeah.
But both of them didn't really look that good. I mean, they offbeat, no rhythm, man. It was definitely social media worthy, though. It was great content.
Oh, yeah. I find most of my entertainment on social media. D'Angelo Brown going for a post up.
The kickball. Another substitution. Deloach is going to check into the game for Scott. Lee's going to take a side out for the Dragons. He finds D'Lo down low. He'll spin baseline.
Ooh, just a little bit too much. That was a nice move, though.
Williams pushes it. He finds Bond in the corner. It's good.
Savannah, they shoot the game. They're coming back.
Gonna give them a little credit. Look, they only down 6 points. They've snuck their way back into this game. finding themselves down six.
That's a good job. Persevering.
Lee with the pass to Brown. Brown with the terrible miss.
Go for the bank shot.
Yeah. Swung cross court to Williams. Williams to Joyner. Joyner down low to Okwudu. Okwudu to Joyner. He'll drive baseline. He'll find Bonds. Bonds for the three. It's good.
Woo.
Adrian Bonds for another big time 3-point shot as he puts his team in position as they only find themselves down one possession. 6 minutes left here in the second half.
Savannah coming alive right now.
And they quietly done it. Like, Brown might have got fouled on a 3-point shot, but they've quietly gotten themselves within striking distance.
Yeah.
There he is, Adrian Bonds.
Putting the whole team on his back.
Adrian Bonds has undoubtedly taken this game over for his team in the second half. He's been the guy to step up for them and be that scoring boost that they so desperately needed. Offensive foul. Offensive foul on D'Angelo Brown. 1-point game with the Tigers in prime position to do what they haven't done, I don't think, all game. I don't think they've been in the lead the entire game, so they have the opportunity right now to take the lead. Zion Williams look to set the offense up. Okwudu will set the screen. Williams doesn't use it. He kicks it out to Bonds. Bonds with the pump fake, and he'll be
I thought
strong.
He made it again. I was going to say, man. But you can tell that he's hungry, though. He's definitely trying to get his team back in the lead.
And listen, I thought he was going to drive. I thought right there was the perfect opportunity for him to drive and attack the rim, especially knowing that the defense is going to play him for the three ball.
It's the last 5 minutes of the game, so I could definitely see he's trying to get his team in the league. They haven't been in the league all game. They've been trailing in all this entire game.
You got to watch the slow trail. There you go. Great recovery on defense. They missed Okwudu down low. You got to get out of the lane. 3 sec. He's going to get a foul. You get Tyler Henry on a foul call. The reach. And I believe that's double bonus. So Adrian Bonds ought to be at the line for two. He'll be off on the first. So now he looks to tie the game up for his team. And he does, 66 the game. Hill slowly brings the ball up court. Looking to run some offense. Dansaw's going to set the screen. He throws it to the rolling Dansaw. He finds Mason. Mason to Hill. Hill's going to try to penetrate over to Johnson. Lou Johnson for the mid-range two, and it's good. Beautiful stroke by Lou Johnson.
That was a nice loose of the pick just then.
Andrew Okwudu picking up his fourth personal foul. And what really wasn't, you know, necessarily a smart play, especially knowing he's a key component for his team. But plenty of time left for the Tigers. What do they do right now with this final stretch left in the game?
Well, you know, I definitely believe that anything is possible at this point in the game. Savannah has been down this whole game. They crawled their way back into the game. They're down two. So I definitely think that they can come back and they can get themselves in the lead. It just comes down to clock management at this point. Clock management and execution.
And 3:49, that is, left to go here in the game. They're going to have to execute down the stretch. They definitely gonna have to execute down the stretch in both ways. You see the Tigers have battled themselves back into this game. As Hill said, he's gonna execute. He hit the mid-range jumper.
Yeah, Lane is definitely, they've definitely turned up their mid-range game.
Savvy play. Tell you what, listen. That's a savvy play by Williams.
He saw that Johnson wasn't paying attention.
Yeah, exactly. He's going to miss his first. But that's savvy.
That's smart.
Go draw the easy foul. You know the ref has to call it.
He missed both of them.
Hill's going to look to run some offense. He's going to drive. He gets a look at the basket. He'll be off. Great hustle there by Dantzall. It's Mason to recover. Hill thinks about the three twice. Dantzall flops. And Hill takes it. 4-3, Daniel Hill.
He definitely should have stepped out and protested that jumper.
I tell you what, especially against a shooter like Daniel Hill. I mean, he's a proven shooter.
He pump fake twice just to see what his defender was going to do, and he still didn't move.
And he took it. That third time was a charm for him. It's the Dragons have pushed their lead back up to 7 with 2:50 left. Williams will look to find an opening. He finds Bond. Bonds will be off for the three. Rebound corralled by Hill. And Hill will look to run a little bit of clock as they hold this lead. 2:30 left in the game. Hill in the mid-range. Great find to Dantzall. Dantzall doing just a little bit of acting. They got to go up strong. Those are, this is how Coach Bazemore showing frustration.
Oh, yeah.
You got to fight through that contact. And, you know, don't necessarily expect a foul. Go up strong, attack the basket. And if you get it, you get it. If you don't, you don't. It will be off on the first free throw. As you see Coach Bazemore getting on him a little bit. He knocks down a second. Joyner takes it out. Sends it in to Williams. Face an 8-point deficit as Williams attacks. Charge.
Turnovers are killing them right now.
I tell you what, Brandon Dantzall has probably been the biggest defensive player thus far for his team. I believe this is his fourth charge take for the whole game. He started off early in the first quarter, or excuse me, the first half. And that's the kind of effort you like to see. Still through two halves, late here in the second half, still having the toughness and the fortitude to stick out the contact and take the charge for his team. Hill pushes it, gets the layup, 2 points.
Hill has definitely been getting the Dragons out in front right now.
That was a good looking attack there by Scott. Trying to get this game back into single digits for his team. Knocks down the first. And he gets the second as well. Good news for the Tigers. They got it back in single digits. So now you're going to see the full court pressure. You're going to start trying to force some turnovers and maybe even look to foul some of the poor free throw shooters for the Dragons that are on the court. The double team comes. Back door to Mason. Mason to Luandre. He'll pass it to Henry in the corner, 4-3. Tyler Henry with the trade ball.
The Dragons are starting to pull away and put an end to this game.
DeLoach. Trey DeLoach with the beautiful and one. Rose above the defender, held in the air. Had the focus and the concentration to finish through contact. He's going to be off, and they'll miss yet another free throw. Hill's going to work through the defense. He'll avoid the double. And it looks like they're going to play the free throw game. It's foul Luandre Johnson. And they'll try to make him hit two free throws. Converts on the first, pushing this back to double digits. Williams gonna push the ball up court. 1 minute left here in the second half. Tell you what, I don't know if I quite see a foul call. But Jordan's going to go to the line. He'll miss another free throw. Tell you what, right now they can't buy a free throw. The Tigers, that is. And with 57 seconds left here, down 10. They're going to need everyone at this point.
Yeah.
He hits on the second. Full court pressure being applied. He'll get to the corner. Near steal there for the Tigers. And not the guy you want to foul if you're the Tigers, as he's probably one of the best free throw shooters on the team. for the Dragons. He'll be off on the first free throw. And he'll hit the second. Scott will get the ball and pushes it ahead. He'll attack and gets the two and a foul. And a foul as it looked like Daniel Hill was in the restricted area. And he'll get himself a chance and an end one opportunity. As he converts on the and one, making this a 9-point game, 44.2 seconds left here in the second half. Andre Johnson looking to inbound. He'll get it into Mason. Mason back to, oh, he almost caught his ankles. He got football. Mason just inadvertently lowering that shoulder on Joyner. And we'll get Brandon Mason at the free throw line to shoot two free throws. Good on the first. Scott will check back in to the game, replacing Bryant. And Mason's good on the second. Williams loses the ball, and good hustle by Mason as he's going to get the timeout for his team. Coach Bazemore is going to waive the 30-second timeout as it counts against them on paper. They don't have to take it, so play will resume. LeAndre inbounds it to Tyler Henry. He'll find Hill. And Hill's going to be fouled by Scott. We'll be shooting more free throws. 26.8 left in regulation. First free throw off the mark for Hill. Coach Bazemore, come on, boy. Get a little chirper from Scott and Hill as he shoots the free throw. Bonds in the corner for three. He'll be off. Bonds again, he'll be off again. Great effort there by Zion Williams. And they're gonna say ball is gonna stick with the Tigers. Williams passes it in to Scott. Scott and Hill get tangled up. Joyner thought about taking a shot. He throws it over to Williams. Williams corner three, good. Too little, too late. 4-3-2-1. And that's going to be the game. Your Dragons take this game by a score of 78-71.
The Dragons have pulled off a great win today. Great job.
It's the Lane College Dragons are able to get the sweep. We thank you all for joining us today and what has been a great day of basketball both ways. They had a great finish by the women as they won in overtime. The men with a little lengthier pull away. We thank you all for joining us again. Tyler Newkirk on the call alongside Jacarri Relf. We hope y'all have a wonderful weekend.
Be safe. Be safe.
Peace. Have a good one.